Hey, good day to everyone. So today I will discuss to you the timeline of the modern polygraph. So this is the brief history of polygraph. Okay, dito natin malalaman paano ba tayo nagkaroon ng tinatawag na polygraph in deception. Okay, because since the dawn of civilization, yung mga tao nun is naghahanap sila ng mga pamamaraan upang madistinguish nila, okay, the truthfulness from lying in those individuals suspected, okay, of criminal wrongdoing. So there are various inventive techniques. Marami silang mga naimbentong mga pamamaraan, okay, for the verification of truth, okay, and the detection of deception, okay, that have been tried over the centuries, kagaya ng mga trial by ordeal na yan, trial by combat. So many of these inventive techniques are ridiculous and cruel, or masasabi nating hindi makatao. Okay? But despite their primitiveness, so its technique was based on the assumption, okay, of that some form of physiological reaction occurred within a person when confronted with a certain stimuli, yung mga pagtatanong na yan, okay, regarding to a specific event under investigation. So and that this physiological reaction would in turn be manifested in certain recognizable external symptoms. May mga simptomas ang mga yan, okay, that were indicative of honesty or deception. Okay, kung makikita mo kasi yung isang tao, lalong-lalong na kapag nagsisinungaling, there are signs or external signs of deception. Okay, so we all know that polygraphy is the science of truth verification. Based upon the psychophysiological analogs. So it is barely 100 years old na yung polygraphy na yan. So we will begin with the pioneers and their contribution. Okay? So in 1730, si Daniel Defoe, he is a British novelist. Okay. He wrote an essay entitled "An Effectual Scheme for the Immediate Preventing of Street Robberies and Suppressing All Other Disorders of Night." Okay, yan yung kanyang isunulat, wherein he recommended that taking the pulse of a suspicious fellow was a practical, effective and humane method for distinguishing truthfulness for from lying. Kaya yan yung sinabi ni Daniel Defoe. So this was an early and insightful suggestion to employ medical science, okay, in the fight against crime. Okay? So yan si Daniel Defoe. Another one is si Jacques de Arsambal. Okay. Itong si Arsambal naman is a French scientist who declared that electricity is generated. Okay, nagkaroon daw ng kuryente, okay, sa katawan ng tao. Okay. Ito yung tinatawag nating external friction. Okay. So in the 1878, okay, science came science first came to the aid of the truth seeker, through the research of Italian physiologist Angelo Mosso. Dito na pumasok si Angelo Mosso. So it was then the that Angelo Mosso used an instrument called a plethysmograph in his research on emotion and fear, okay, in subjects undergoing questioning. And Angelo Mosso studied, okay, the effects of these variables on their cardiovascular and respiratory activity. So yun yun naman ang na-contribute ni Angelo Mosso, yung tinatawag nating plethysmograph. Okay? Si Angelo Mosso kasi pinag-aralan niya yung blood circulation, okay, and breathing patterns, okay, and how this changes, how or how this changes yung breathing pattern or blood circulation under a certain stimuli. Okay, so the use of a plethysmograph revealed the periodic undulation or waves, okay, in a subject's blood pressure caused by the respiratory cycle in response to a certain stimuli. Okay, so Angelo Mosso was the first scientist. Okay, ito itong tandaan niyo is he is the first scientist to report on experiments in which he observes that person's breathing pattern, okay, yung breathing pattern ng isang tao will change under a certain stimuli, and that this change in turn causes variations in their blood pressures and the pulse rate. Okay, so yan si Angelo Mosso. Okay, and another one is si Christian Hans Stolting. Siya yung founder ng Stolting company, which became a leading product supplier on physiological, psychological, and psychophysiological measurement during his time. Okay, next is si Charles Samson Ferry. Okay, so si Charles Samson Ferry naman is a scientist who discovered the electrodermal response, okay, caused by an increase in the action of the heart and vital energy converted with human emotion. Okay, so although not for the purpose of detecting deception, noong 1892 naman is si Sir James Mackenzie, okay, constructed the what we call the clinical polygraph. Okay, so ang clinical polygraph na yan is an instrument, okay, to be used for medical examination. Okay, so ginagamit siya sa for medical examination with the capability of to simultaneously record the undulated line tracings of the vascular pulses. Okay, so yung nagawa ni Mackenzie, yung clinical polygraph, clinical instrument na yan, clinical polygraph, is ginagamit sa medical purposes, not for a medical examination, not for lie detection. Okay, so itong clinical polygraph na to is records the undulated line tracings, okay, of the vascular pulses, okay, by way of stylus, okay, onto revolving drum of smoke paper. Okay, so until the 19th century, or before the 19th century, especially kay Cesar Lombroso. Okay, so there is no measuring device before the detection of deception. Okay, wala pang ginagamit doon. Okay, so the first use of a scientific instrument designed to measure the physiological response for this purpose, okay, came in 1995, okay, when the Italian physician and psychiatrist and pioneer of criminology, okay, no other than Cesar Lombroso, okay, modified an existing instrument. Okay, ano yung instrument, existing instrument? So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya yung nag-invento. Okay? Meron lang siyang binago. Okay? O meron lang siyang yung tinatawag nating modification. Yan yung tinatawag nating hydrosphygmograph. Okay? So the hydrosphygmograph is used. Okay? Use this modified device in his experiment. Okay? Para ma-measure niya yung physiological changes. Okay? That occurs on the crime suspect blood pressures and pulse rate, okay, during police interrogation. Okay, so notably Lombroso's early device for measuring pulse rate and blood pressure is similar to the cardiosphygmograph or cardiospirograph component of the contemporary polygraph. Although Cesar Lombroso did not invent the hydrosphygmograph, hindi naman siya yung naka-invento, pero siya yung unang gumamit nito, ano. Okay? He is accorded the distinction of being the first person to have used the instrument successfully, okay, as a means for determining the truthfulness from deception in crime suspects. Okay. So on several occasions, he used the hydrosphygmograph in actual cases to assist the police in the identification of criminals. Okay. The next is si George Sticker, the first person to suggest the use of the galvanograph for detecting deception. Yan naman yung contribution ni George Sticker. Okay, so until in 1906, si Sir James Mackenzie ulit, okay, refined his clinical polygraph in 1892. Okay, when he devised the clinical ink polygraph, okay, with the help of Lancashire watchmaker Sebastian Shaw. Okay, so this itong instrumento na na-develop ulit ni Sir James Mackenzie used a clockwork mechanism for the paper rolling and time maker movement, and they produce ink recordings. May ink na yan yung ginagamit nila, okay, of physiological functions that were easier to acquire and to interpret, okay, para madaling ma-interpret kung ano man yung kalalabasan ng mga tracings. So interestingly, it has been written that the modern polygraph is really a modification of the ink of the clinical ink polygraph of Dr. Mackenzie. Okay? Okay, so let's continue. So in 1907, si Otto Veragut naman, he introduced the what we call psychogalvanic reflex. So when we say psychogalvanic reflex, this is an idea that electrical phenomenon was due to the activity of the sweat glands. So dyan kasi lumalabas yung mga sweat natin. Kasi ang sabi nila is merong kuryente yung katawan natin. Okay. So 1908, si Hugo Munsterberg, he advocated that the light test based on lie detector should be admissible as evidence. Yan naman ang na-contribute ni Hugo Munsterberg, the idea that the result, okay, coming from the lie detector is should be admissible as evidence. Okay. So in 1914, si Vittorio Benucci naman is who is an Italian psychologist, okay, discovered the method for calculating the quotient of the inhalation and the exhalation time. Okay, ano yung inhalation and exhalation? Yung inhale natin, yung paghinga natin, yung inhale and the exhale. Okay? As a means of verifying the truth and detecting deception in a subject. Okay? So, using a pneumograph, gumamit siya ng pneumograph. Okay? Ang pneumograph kasi is isa yung device, okay, that okay, a device that recorded the subject's breathing patterns. Ang nire-record niya is yung paghinga natin, and it is being placed and sa ngayon na it is being placed at the thoracic part and the abdominal part of our body. Okay, so si Vittorio Benucci conducted the experiment regarding the respiratory symptoms, okay, of lying. So ang sabi ni Benucci, okay, he concluded that lying caused an emotional change within the subject, okay, that resulted in detectable respiratory changes that were indicative of deception. Okay, so that is the contribution of Vittorio Benucci. Okay, the quotient, calculating the quotient of inhalation and the exhalation time. Okay, so aside from Benucci, we have Dr. William Moulton Marston. Okay. He is an American attorney and also a psychologist. Okay. He is credited with inventing an early form of lie detector when in 1915, okay, he developed, ito naman yung kanyang na-develop, yung discontinuous systolic blood pressure. Okay. Yan yung na-develop, the discontinuous systolic blood pressure test, okay, which would later become the or become one of the component of the modern polygraph. So Dr. Marston technique used the what we call the standard blood pressure cuff. Gumamit na siya ng blood pressure cuff at saka yung stethoscope, okay, to take intermittent systolic blood pressure readings, yung mga ginagamit ng doktor ngayon, okay, of a suspect during questioning for the purpose of detecting deception. Okay, yan si Dr. William Moulton Marston. Okay. So aside from Marston, we have Harold Burt. Okay. Si Harold Burt naman is he determined that respiratory changes were indicative of deception. Okay, ang sabi ni Harold Burt, yung respiratory changes natin ay isang indikasyon ng deception. Okay? And he found out that changes in the systolic blood pressure were of greater value. Mas malaki daw ang value ng changes ng blood pressure natin in determining deception than the changes in respiration. Okay. Yun naman ang sabi niya. Okay. So in 1921, John A. Larson naman is a Canadian psychologist. Okay, na nagtrabaho sa Berkeley Police Department in California. So si Larson developed of what many consider to be original lie detector. Okay, when he added the item of respiration rate to the blood pressure. Okay, marami ang nagsasabi na ang gawa ni Larson ay yun yung original lie detector. So pinangalanan ni John A. Larson yung kanyang instrument, okay, na ang binigyan ng pangalan ay polygraph. Okay? So yan na yung polygraph natin. Okay? What is meant by polygraph? So on what word derived yung tinatawag nating polygraph? Okay, so the polygraph is a word derived from the Greek language, meaning many writings. So bakit many writings? Since it could read several physiological responses at the same time and document these responses on a revolving drum of smoke paper. Okay, smoke paper yung ginagamit. Okay? So using his polygraph, okay? Si John Larson was the first person to continually and simultaneously measure changes in the subject's pulse rate. Okay? Hindi lang sa pulse rate, sa blood pressure, and the respiratory. Okay? Yan yung measure ni Larson, the pulse rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate during interrogation. Okay? So his polygraph was used extensively and with much yung tinatawag nating success in criminal investigation. Okay, so that is John Larson. Okay, next naman is si Leonard Keeler. Okay, si Leonard Keeler who gained the what we call the first-hand experience, okay, in polygraph interrogation as a result of working. Magkatrabaho kasi yan si John Larson at saka si Leonard Keeler, okay, doon sa Berkeley Police Department, okay, working with John Larson at the Berkeley Police Department, work to devise a polygraph that use ink pens. Dito na mayroon ng ink pen yung ginamit na device ni Leonard Keeler, okay, or Leonard Keeler, for recording the relative changes in a subject's blood pressure. Okay, yan na yung yung mga ink pens na yan ang nagre-record ng changes sa blood pressure ng subject, sa pulse rate, and the respiratory patterns. Okay, thus eliminating the need of smoking the paper and preserving it with the shellac. Dati kasi yung na-invento ni Larson ay smoke paper. Okay, so yan yung na-invento ni Leonard Killer. Okay? So, in 1926, the killer polygraph came on the market as the new and improved lie detector. Okay? The killer polygraph was an enhanced version of John Larson's polygraph. Okay, si John Larson kasi sinasabing siya yung father ng polygraph. Okay, so in 1930, si Captain Clarence Dilley designed the what we call Lee psychograph. Okay, ang Lee psychograph consists of four units: the chart drive, pneumograph, cardiograph, and stimulus signal unit. And next is si Chester Darrow. He made the third modification. Siya yung gumawa ng third modification ng Larson cardio-pneumo psychograph by adding the what called galvanometer. Okay? So another contribution of Leonard Killer. Okay, in 1938 Leonard Killer further refined. Okay, binago na na or meron na naman siyang may dinagdag kaysa kanyang instrumento. Okay, when he added the third physiological measuring component, dinagdag niya yung pangatlong component ng kanyang polygraph machine for the detection of deception. Yan na yung psychogalvanometer. Okay. Ang psychogalvanometer is a component that measured changes in the subject galvanic skin resistance during questioning. Okay. So in so doing, that's signaling the birth of the polygraph as we know today. Okay. So next is in 1939, okay? Noong 1939 na si Leonard Killer, he patented, okay, of what is now understood as the prototype of the modern polygraph, the Killer polygraph. So today Leonard Killer is known as the father of modern polygraph. Siya nga yun yung tinatawag na father of modern polygraph. Okay? So in 1947, si John Reed, a lawyer from Chicago, Illinois, developed the what we call the control question technique or yung CQT, a polygraph technique that incorporated the control question for comparison. Okay? Which were designed to be emotionally arousing for non-deceptive subject or less emotionally arousing for the subject deceptive subjects than the relevant question previously used. So the CQT replaced the relevant irrelevant question technique, okay, which used relevant or irrelevant question during the polygraph examination. So this was the major breakthrough in polygraph methodology, the Reed control question technique. Okay, so in 1948, si Leonard Killer nagpatayo siya ng kauna-unahang polygraph school. Okay, in Chicago, Illinois, the Killer Polygraph Institute. Okay. Next is si Paul Wilhelm and Donald Burns. They were known as lie detector specialists in Michigan City, Indiana. Okay, they invented the electronic psychometric using electrodermal response as a basis of lie for lie detection. So, ang sabi nila na yung kanilang lie detection test using their instrument is 95% accurate. Okay? So in 1960, Clive Baxter, okay? So he developed the Baxter zone comparison technique. Okay? So a polygraph technique which is primarily involved, okay, an alteration of the RAID question sequencing. Okay. So Clive Baxter introduced the also introduced, okay, a quantification system, okay, of chart analysis, thus making it more objective and specific than before. Okay. So this system for the numerical evaluation of the physiological data collected from the polygraph charts that has been adapted as a standard procedure in the polygraph field today. Okay. So in 1962 na kasi, the study of the use of computers in the physiological detection of deception has been or has progressed through several phases. Okay. So in the late 1970s, si Dr. Joseph Kubis, okay, was the first researcher to use potential computer application for the purpose of polygraph chart analysis. Okay. So next is noong 1980s na, okay, there are research conducted, okay, especially kay doctors John Kircher and David Ruskin. Okay, they conducted a research on computerized polygraph. Okay, so in 1988 they developed the what we call computer assisted polygraph system, or yung CAPS, which incorporated the first algorithm to be used for evaluating physiological data collected for diagnostic purposes. Okay, so in 1992, the polygraph made its official entrance into the computer age. Okay, so next is Dr. Dale Olsen and Jan Harris. Okay, so at the Hopkins University, they completed a software program called the PolyScore. Ang nagawa naman nila is, ang naimbento naman nila is yung computer software na PolyScore. Okay, when we say PolyScore, it is a computerized polygraph chart scoring algorithm that uses statistical probability to arrive at truthfulness or deception. Okay, so gumamit sila ng PolyScore 3.0, a polygraph software, okay, developed by analyzing the data from polygraph examinations administered in 624 real criminal cases in which 303 suspects were non-deceptive and 321 suspects were deceptive. Okay. So in 2003, they also used the PolyScore 5.1. Na-invento rin yan. A polygraph software, okay, developed by analyzing data naman from polygraph examinations administered in 1,411 criminal cases provided by the U.S. Department of Defense Polygraph Institute for the Study of Comparison Purposes. Okay, another one is 2003 ulit, the U.S. Department of Energy Commission Review Committee of the National Academy of Sciences to study the scientific evidence on
polygraph. Okay? So that is the brief history of polygraph. Okay, before I will end my discussion, I will leave you a quote. Okay, by George Evans. Ang sabi niya is every student can learn, just not on the same day, okay, or in the same way. So thank you and God bless.